The next group of operators is known as the logical operators. The result of evaluation of the logical operators also leads us to getting the answer true or false or Boolean values, yes or no. The three logical operators are, this is called as the logical AND, this is called as the logical OR, and this is called as the logical NOT. Let me tell you what AND, OR and NOT mean. Suppose I say, let's say A is equal to 10 and B is equal to 5. If I ask the question, is A equal to 10 and B equal to 6? Now A is equal to 10 but B is not equal to 6. So the AND condition fails. That means if both the parts or multiple parts are true, then only it is considered as true. OR means either one of them can be true, because if I say, is A equal to 10 or B equal to 6, A is equal to 10, so I'm fine. So it is still true. So what we'll do is, we will try to understand these three logical operators, AND, OR and NOT, using a sum of simple code examples. So what I have done is, I have declared an integer variable A is 20, B is 10, and I have declared the third variable called as result. So what I am doing here is, I am using an if. I am going a little ahead, okay, but you don't have to worry about how if works. All that if does is, it checks whether both of these conditions are true. Is 20 greater than 20? It is false. Since the first part is false, it will not even go to the second part. The reason being, AND means both should be true. When the first part is true, there is no point going to the second part and checking, because even if it is true, still the entire result would have been false. So this is false and this does not really matter. So now if I print this condition, okay, if A greater than 20 and B greater than 9, here it will not print this particular statement. Okay, so A is not greater than 20 because A is equal to 20. So this statement is not going to be printed, although B is greater than 9. Now see what I am doing. I am asking, if A greater than 30, A is greater than 30, false, 20 is not greater than 30, but B, which is 10, is greater than 9. So here it will print the message, only B is true. All right, only B is true. Now let's take a look at the NOT logical operator. Here what I am doing is, forget this NOT. I am saying A is equal to 20. It is true. And B is equal to 9. This is false. So this entire thing is false. But this logical NOT, what it does is, if it is true, it reverses it to false. If it is false, it reverses it to true. So since this entire thing was false, opposite of false is true. So result will have the value 1 in it now. So if I print result here, it is going to print the value 1. Now take a look at one more if statement. Forget this NOT. A is equal to 10. This is false. It will not even go to this side, because false and anything is always going to be false. But since it is inverted, that means it is reversed. So not false is going to be equal to true. So if true, it is going to print this particular message, if true. Now you need to understand a few important aspects of these logical operators. They are extensively used along with relational and equality operators in control flow statements like if, else and looping statements. There's an interesting word here. Individual operand is a Boolean value. That is, it is true or false. Suppose I say A is equal to 10. Now if I say if A, okay, what is the value of A? It will be substituted with 10. 10 is a non-zero number. That's why this is considered to be as true. So if you do something like this, if 2 and 3, this will print the message as true, because this is a non-zero number is considered as true. This is also a non-zero number. This is considered as true. So the output of this is going to print the message true. So true means if any of these individual components has a non-zero value, it is considered to be true. So in this case, since A was 10, it was considered to be true. Let's say now A is equal to 0. Now if I say if A, and if I try to print true, it's not going to print, because A has been replaced with 0. 0 is always false in C. So nothing will be printed. But if I do something like this, is if 0 equal to 0. Okay, I'm going a little ahead. In the next step, you're going to do if 0 equal to 0. Here it will print true. because it is comparing this side with this side. Both are equal, therefore it's going to print the message. So this is very different from what I am doing here.